Welcome to Triforce Women's Wrestling. I am your host, Tyler Wolf, Tyler X, whatever you want to call me. Tyler X, I'm going to say Tyler X, and this is Triforce Women's Wrestling. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys love this show. We have a wonderful main event lined up for today. Our main event is none other than Toni Rose going against Natasha Charms. And that will be an interesting thing to see, especially with Toni Rose and Nat Charms in the mix. Our first matchup of the evening is Jessica B going against Ruby Rhodes. This is going to be a wonderful first matchup of the evening. Here we go with our first matchup of the evening.
The following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere match. Making her way to the ring from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Jessica B.
Sorry, Jessica B's been the way to the ring. Mind you, lately she has been, and I'm gonna lie, she has actually been showing some heart, especially inside the ring. And we'll see how it turns out between her and Ruby Rhodes, especially in this one-on-one matchup, this Falls Count Anywhere matchup. So this will be interesting to see as far as between her and Ruby Rhodes, because this is the first time they've ever went one-on-one against each other.
From Columbia, South Carolina, Rose Rhodes.
She has been on a roll lately too, as far as against the opponents that she's been facing. It's like, man. Like I said, this is the first time they've ever went against each other. Got the arm, puts Ruby Rhodes onto the ground. I got the upper hand in this matchup. Probably which I feel again puts Ruby on the ropes. Ooh, nice sit down. for her to want it, but no reversal from Jessica B. So far, Jessica B's got the upper hand in this matchup. Nice takedown from Jessica. Jessica B, sorry for being a little distracted, just trying to get the thing up for what you call it. There we go. Reversal. Ooh, nice takedown. Jessica B. Now going after the arm. Trying to hurt the hand. Ends it with a knee drop to the back. That's gotta hurt. What's up, Amanda? How are you? In the power stand position. Uses the steel steps as a weapon. Like I said, this is a false count in this matchup. Nice reversal from Ruby Rhodes. Picks up Jessica from the ground. Goes for a boot to the face. That's gotta hurt. Goes for the pin quickly. One leg kicks out. Not that that was going to be it, but nope. Reversal. Misses the back. Gets to get. Picks up Ruby. Blocks the kick. Rose into the announce table, but nothing happens. That was reality. She would have been thrown literally over the announce table. Reversal. Kick to the gut. Going for a backpack maneuver on. Ruby Rhodes goes for the pin quickly. Kicks out quickly. Gets his kick. Nice reversal. Kicks from the gut. Goes for the DET maneuver. Picks up Ruby. Kicks her in the gut. What's she going for? Going for the future shock maneuver on Ruby Rhodes. Now trying to end it with a super kick on Ruby. Gets up. Super kick is applied. Nice combination of moves from Jessica B. Goes for the pin. One, two, kicks out. Almost. Jessica thought that would have ended her, but no. Not even those combination of moves would take down Ruby Rhodes. Reversal from Rhodes with the jawbreaker maneuver. Rhodes are onto the steel steps. Picks up Jessica B. Throws her again. She tripped. Picks up Jessica. Throws her back into the ring. Going for a springboard. From the ropes. Phenomenal forearm is applied on Jessica. Jessica's still clinging onto the ropes. Still in this matchup. Ooh, takes down Jessica just like that. Rolls outside. Duck. Clothesline. Nice reversal from Jessica. Kicks Ruby in the back. Turns her around. Goes for the knee turbo maneuver on Ruby Rhodes onto that mat. That's gotta hurt. Now trying to end her with a super kick yet again. Hopefully this will be it. Super kick misses. Scratch up the strike. Blow for blow. Nice reversal from Jessica. Ducks. Clothesline from Ruby. Picks up Jessica. Pushes away Ruby. Kick. Turns around. Kick. Throws her onto the turnbuckle. uses the steel post as a weapon. Picks up Ruby. Pressure from Rhodes. Rhodes with that quick rocket kick maneuver on Jessica B. Goes for the pin. 1, 2, 3. Oh no! Kicks out at 2. Still in this matchup. Picks up Jessica. Kicks her in the gut. Kicks up Ruby. Uses the barricade as a weapon. That's gotta hurt. That side barricade, that's gotta hurt. Misses the jab. Tries to pick up Ruby. Ruby with the reversal. Kicks her in the gut. Picks up Ruby with that spinning suplex maneuver. Goes for the pin quickly. 1, 2, almost, no. Getting a little frustrated at Ruby. What up, Bat TNA? How are you doing? Picks up Ruby. Ruby with the reversal now. Locks the slap with a punch. Jab. With the jab. Gets jabbed back by Ruby. Grabs Ruby by the neck. Uses the steel post as a weapon yet again. Does it again with the steel post on Ruby. Picks up Ruby Rhodes. Throws her to the side of the mat. That's gotta hurt. Picks up Rhodes again. Ooh, nice reversal. Ooh, neck-breaking maneuver from Ruby Rhodes to Jessica. Picks up Jessica. Jessica with the reversal now. Jab. That second jab turns around. Ooh, nice spinning heel kick. Picks up Ruby. He tries to pick up Ruby again, but Ruby saw that and then encountered Jessica. Picks up Ruby. Locks the jab with the kick. Kick. What are you going for? Going for the future shark maneuver again on Ruby. For a knee drop move on to the head of Ruby Rhodes. Turns her around, goes for the pin. 1, 2, kicks out. Jab. Second and third jab. Reversal from Ruby. Reversal from Jessica. Now climbing onto the ramp. That steel ramp. Goes for the bulldog onto that ramp. And yes, it does affect, it did affect Jessica B on that too. Going for the arm now of Ruby. The way it takes to hurt her opponent. Disrespectful words from Jessica. Picks up Ruby. It's on the gut. Goes for it yet again on Ruby. Trying to end it with a super kick. Hopefully it'll connect so she'll win the matchup. And she misses yet again. Goes for that fat back maneuver yet again on Ruby. Goes for the pin. Goes for the pin quickly. 1, 2, kicks out. Jessica's trying to figure out a way to defeat Ruby. Picks up Ruby. Super kick, almost at it, but no, saw that again. Reversal again from Jessica. Just one more time in the head of Ruby Rhodes in that decision maneuver. Kicks out Rhodes. Kicks down Rhodes. Goes for the pin quickly. 1, 2, no. That didn't stop her. Kick. Goes for a neck-breaking maneuver. Turns it around, goes for a submission maneuver on Jessica B, trying to make a tap. Does not tap out, still in this matchup. Don't know if they're trying to fool, but they're trying to hurt each other. They're not driving in. Ooh, that's gotta hurt. Goes for the pin. Kicks out again, still in this matchup. have Jessica B right here now. Dex blows on from Jessica. Jessica picks up Ruby. Dex kick, knee strike. Reversal arm drag from Jessica. Kick. Reversal. Jab. Kick. Kick. Jab. With the punch. Next event. Kick. Dex. German suplex is applied. 1-2 kicks out. Wasting too much momentum in this matchup. She better be careful. Goes for the spinning suplex yet again on Ruby. Now trying to end it with the super kick. If it connects, it'll be game over for Ruby. And it connects. Goes for the pin quickly. 1-2 No, man, she must have resiliency on her. Trying to win the matchup, like, oh my god. Nice reversal from Ruby. Blocks the kick. Gets in the gut. Pushes away Ruby. Goes with a future shot yet again. Turn connector with the super kick. And it's applied again. Will this be it? Goes for the pin. 1-2-3 Did whatever it took to win that matchup. Both fought admirably, but Jessica B wanted to win that matchup.
Here is your winner, Jessica B.
Like I said, Jessica B wanted to win that matchup. That was literally interesting. Here we go with our next matchup. Allison Charms going against Miyako. I'm gonna lie, the first matchup kind of sparked, like, oh my god. Now we'll see how this second matchup will turn out. And here we go. Allison Charms making her way to the ring. Allison Charms didn't make her debut last week, but now she is going against Miyako in her second matchup.
And her opponent. from Yamaguchi, Japan, the Dragon.
Like I said, Yakuza is trying to reclaim what was rightfully theirs. I'm pretty sure that Miyako still is not giving up as far as winning either the Pure Championship or the World Championship. Nothing's gonna stop her. Just saying. If you guys don't know, you don't know like I do. And here we go with our second matchup of the evening. Allison Charms going against Miyako. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Nice maneuver from Miyako with that connected maneuver. Gonna take him back off the charge. Allison with the reversal picks up Allison. Going for it. Ooh! Tie-breaking maneuver. Reversal from Allison. That back elbow straight. Takes down Miyako with the low drop kick. Reversal from Miyako. Kick. Blocks the kick. Throws Alice to the rope, still clinging on. Punches her in the face. What's she going for? Ooh, that's gotta hurt. Cutting maneuver from the ropes. Going for a top rope maneuver. The ref starts to count. Jumps with the back elbow, almost had her from the back of the head. Reversal from Miyako. Reversal from Alice. What a takedown from Miyako. Picks up Allison. Picks her in the face, not once but twice. Takes her down in a safe position. Grabs her by the neck. Uses the turnbuckle as a weapon to put her in the corner. Nice reversal from Charms. Reversal from Miyako. Allison throws Miyako. Jumps. Ducks. Ooh, almost at the straight. Ooh, what a leg sweeping maneuver from Allison. Grabs her. Now going up the arm with Miyako. Ouch, she's got her hurt. Now going with the arm bar. Driving with the arm with Miyako. Picks up Miyako. Miyako with the reversal. Pushes away Miyako. Going for her Kurana maneuver. So the chair getting up and coming onto the ropes and runs to Miyako, misses the body splash. Grabs her nose, gets thrown outside, still coming onto the ropes. Trying to bring it. Going for a power drain maneuver on Miyako. Watching on Miyako with the finisher. With her finisher. It's in the gut. One next flex goes for the pin. One. Two kicks out still in this matchup. Even Allison was shocked. I think Allison thought that Miyako was being too cocky, but no, Miyako is a fighter. Throws Miyako to the ropes, misses the drop kick, picks up Allison by the neck, using the turnbuckle as a weapon, keeps using it, that's gotta hurt, using a steel turnbuckle. Even though it's covered with the pad, it still hurts. Ooh, what a quick cutter, goes for the pin. One, two, almost three, telling the ref to count faster. Blame the ref to count faster. Reversal from Allison. Going for a back-breaking move on Miyako. Picks up Miyako. Straight. Straight. Ducks. picks her up. Goes for a quick spine busting maneuver. Finds to the turnbuckle. Reversal. Ooh, nice maneuver from Miyako. You already know Miyako's getting pumped up. Ooh, that was a nice leg drop maneuver. Picks up Allison. Strike. Goes for a sling blade on Allison. Comeback after a comeback, nice. Reversal from Allison. Gets slapped, gets pulled the ropes. Goes outside, still pulling onto ropes. Punches her in the face, does that move again. That cutting maneuver from the ropes. Using the middle ropes. Jumps to the top. Trying to hurt her with the dive. Jumps with an elbow drop but misses. Gets back into the ring quickly. It's put in the same position by Allison. Allison going after the neck of Miyako. Trying to burn down her opponent. But not waste too much momentum. Reversal from Allison. Almost had the cutter maneuver. It's the body splash. Gets hammer thrown outside the ring. This is a false kind of English matchup. So I'm going to let Allison through Bianca outside. Reversal from Bianca kicks him again. Back into the ring. Almost had to maneuver, but now Allison with that major reversal misses the springboard dive. Completely. Sorry. Allison still coming onto the ropes. Does that same move yet again on Allison. That cutting maneuver from the middle rope just gotta hurt. So, Allison. Allison with a reversal. Gets back into the ring. Almost. Jumps back. That was actually a nice move to get back in the ring. Considering the gut. Was she going for the standing Shania maneuver? No, going for the long cutting maneuver on Allison. Allison slowly but surely getting up. Reversal. Ooh, jumping over strength from Miyako. And has that dragon suit maneuver on Allison from the ground. Allison flex out of the submission. Now going for a powerbomb on Miyako. 1, 2, 3. Nice win from Allison Jones. Feelings, but that was actually a good matchup. Miyako congratulates Allison. Huh. Well, cheers on. I think Allison was actually kind of shocked about that too.
think Al's a little shocked about that too. Our next matchup, we got Alexia Starrs going against Lilith Ramirez in one-on-one action. This rivalry has been epic literally on the first week when it started, because she wanted answers as to why she was attacked by Alexia Starrs after their matchup 2 weeks ago. And let's just say the words that came out of Alexia Starrs' mouth was not good, so that is why this rivalry is happening. Charges into the ring and just attacks Alexia Starrs even before the matchup, so she is upset at Alexia. Man, I've never seen this side of Lilith Ramirez ever. I think everybody was shocked to see Lilith Ramirez upset like that. Like the words that came out of her mouth last week, I think that kind of got to Lilith Ramirez. Blocks the slab with a punch. Carnival tie-up gets the arm. Puts down Alexia Starrs. Trying to hurt Alexia by any means necessary. Reversal from Alexia attacking the arm. Now double reversal. Fought out the hole. Nice reversal from Lilith. Blocks the kick. Drops Lilith. Turns her around. Goes for a submission maneuver. Going for the Grand Slam stretch. Trying to hurt Ramirez. Make sure that she taps, but no, she is a fighter. Fights out the whole Stones matchup. Kicks the leg in the gut, goes for that quick DDT maneuver. Picks up Alexia. Alexia with the sweep. Kicks her in the back. Ramirez in the back. Turns around Lilith. So here's her down to the ground. Nice reversal from Lilith Ramirez. Starts with the reversal attack to go. Those lines. Lilith outside the ring. Now she's getting angry. She was actually kind of shocked that Ramirez would do that. I'm pretty sure she was shocked that Ramirez did that too. Reversal from Alexia attacking the back. Comes around, throws her back into the ring because you have to win by submission inside the ring. Reversal from Ramirez. Throws her to the corner. Going for the Bronco Buster maneuver on Alexia Starrs. Ends up with an uppercut on Starrs. Puts her down in the corner. Stomp. Going for a springboard leg drop on Alexia Starrs from the bottom rope. Now going for a springboard. Jumps. Phenomenal form is applied. Now trying to get back up. Kicks down Alexia. Drags her away from the ropes. Maybe going for a submission. Alexia with that interfering maneuver on Ramirez. Picks up Ramirez. Nice reversal from Ramirez. Starts with the reversal now. Ramirez throws Ramirez to the corner. Nope, reversal from Lilith. Nice maneuver from Lilith Ramirez. Turns her around. Goes for a submission. And make a tap. Said this is a submission matchup, so you have to win by submission. Fight side of the hold still in this matchup. Elbow strike to the face of Lilith Ramirez. Reversal from Lilith with that punch. Ooh, punches down Alexia Starrs.
goes to the top rope. Down there to get up. Going for a top rope maneuver. Jumps with the... Ooh, almost with that spinning body splash maneuver. Throws Lilith back into the ring. Now she might be going for a springboard. This is the spear. Sorry for stuttering. It's all good. Ooh, what a maneuver. Turns her around. Now she goes for the submission. Fight sounds a little fun this matchup. Ramirez in the gut, puts her in the corner. Reversal from Ramirez, punching her back. Kicks her in the gut. Picks her up, going for the double knee strike to the gut. Turns her away from the ropes so she won't get a rope break. Turns her around. Going for a giant suplex. Now going for the crossface maneuver. Has to let go because her foot's on the ropes. Picks up Stars. Throws it to the corner. The Rose are outside the ring. Going for an OMG maneuver. That was awesome from the next start. I was shocked about that. I did not expect Lilith to attack Alexia Stars the way she did. Throws Alexia back into the ring. I think she is getting angry. Goes to the top rope. Jumps with the double chop that misses. Picks up a little with the neck breaking maneuver. I legit think that Alexia Stars got under Lilith's skin after what she did after the attack that happened 2 weeks ago. Even though she got karma last week, she says, "No, I'm not even satisfied yet." Like, what the heck? Reversal from Lilith Ramirez. Goes to the top rope. Man, she's getting pumped up. Jumps with that Phoenix Splash on Alexia Stars. Turns her around. Goes for that crossface yet again on Alexia. And Alexia has no choice but to tap. Man. This is the side of Lilith Ramirez I'm shocked to see. I did not expect her to do what she did last week. Well, you know, before the match started, one man.
Lilith Ramirez.
I think those words got to Lilith Ramirez and put it into her match. Like, man. I don't know about you guys, but man. Our next matchup, we got Casey Rodriguez going against Brittany Payne. And I'm pretty sure how I know this is going to be ending because lately, Casey Rodriguez has been getting under Heather Ray's skin. Man. I'm sorry, but I'm still shocked on what Lilith Ramirez had to do. Like, I was shocked on the fact that Lilith Ramirez, like, resulted into that as far as attacking Alexia before their match started. Like, man, I did not see that one coming. As soon as this starts, we'll see how this turns out.
Here we go.
Like, this is literally the first match within her rivalry against Heather Ray. This is the first match that I've ever seen Casey Rodriguez in a match during their rivalry. Like, I'm never gonna lie, like, I just like this new attitude of hers lately, and it's like, man, she's showing pure dominance. Like, she, like, even though, like, she's actually getting, I feel like she's getting under Heather Ray's skin because, I don't know, this is the side that everyone wants to see.
Making her way to the ring, from Shreveport, Louisiana, Casey Rodriguez.
I'm gonna lie, this is a sign I always wanted to see in her, as far as what she did to Heather Ray for the past few weeks. To the ring, mind you. I just want to see how this turns out because she's going against none other than Casey Rodriguez. This one-on-one matchup between Casey Rodriguez and Brittany Payne. This is the charge reversal from Rodriguez, though. Throws Payne to the ropes, to the corner. Nice reversal from Payne. Ooh! Takes him down with that single drop kick. Now, kicking Brittany Payne. He's been so keen with the reversal. Now reversal from Rodriguez. Turns around, Brittany Payne going for her to run a maneuver. Man, she is charging at Brittany Payne. Brittany Payne going for the pin. Quickly one, two, kicks out. Gets back into the ring. Does that single leg drop kick again on Brittany Payne. Turns around. Attacking the hand of Rodriguez. Stop it. Rodriguez with a jump. Reversal from Payne. Arm drag maneuver from Rodriguez. Throws Brittany Payne to the corner. Turns her around. Backs up, goes for a signature maneuver on Brittany Payne from the corner. Goes for the pin quickly. One. Two kicks out. Goes to the top rope, trying to finish her with that one move on the top rope. Telling her to get up. I know it's coming. Jumps. Almost had it. Almost had it. Now going for the quick maneuver, but saw that one a mile away. It's on the gut. Ooh, goes for that single leg drop kick again. Goes for the pin quickly. One. Two kicks out. Picks up Payne. Throws her to the corner. Goes for the signature maneuver again, but misses. Low drop kick from Brittany Payne. In the corner, goes for the cannonball maneuver on Casey Rodriguez. Turns her around, goes for the pin. One, and then kicks out. Not even that's going to stop her. Reversal from Rodriguez. Turns her around. Knee drop to the back. Picks up Payne, throws it to the corner, goes for a signature maneuver yet again, and almost had it, but no, reversal from Payne, grabs it by the neck, to gain the upper hand real quick, going for the Black Widow maneuver on Rodriguez. Rodriguez does not tap out. Ooh, what a takedown maneuver. Just taunting Brittany Payne when she's outside. Now she goes outside. Ooh, what a DDT. Picks up Payne. Pushes away Rodriguez. Going for a powerbomb. Goes for the pin quickly. One. The win laps at Casey Rodriguez. Not happy about that loss. And here comes the champ, of course, gloating. What is this all about? I think Heather Ray is just gloating that Casey Rodriguez is saying fact that she lost her matchup, feeling like she's going to retain the title. But again, the match is at Bloodline. Our next matchup, we got Rebecca and Teresa going against Power and Glory yet again. And we'll see how this turns out as far as this matchup. Like I said, don't get too cocky, Heather Ray. That's all I gotta say. I thought after that match, Heather Ray was gonna come out. Oh, she did. She just only came out to gloat against Case Rodriguez to some fact that she lost her match against Brittany Payne, which I thought was messed up. And she's just laughing because she knows that her matchup against her is at Bloodlines, and it's not this Sunday, it's the following Sunday. And it's like, don't gloat, because you don't know, you literally don't know what's going to happen, you know? So. Teresa Teresa making her way to the ring. And after that, it'll be her twin sister, Rebecca, making her way to the ring. Mind you, when I say this, they did defeat Power and Glory last week. But we'll see how Angel Adams does this week against with Shayla Dar in her corner. Tag team entrance. That way they'll come from each other to the ring right now. She is a former North American champion. And they do deserve the opportunity for the tag team championships. The same fact that they did defeat Power and Glory last week, so.
And their opponents, the Queen, Angel.
This will be interesting to see because Shayla Dar is teaming up with her Power and Glory team member, Angel Adams, who is one half of the tag team champions. Because the other half is none other than Heather Ray. Tornado tag matchup with Rebecca and Teresa, premium sisters going against Power and Glory. Nice reversal from Rebecca. Rebecca going after Shayla Dar. Angel Adams going after Teresa. Teresa with the reversal now. Shayla Dar with the upper hand on Rebecca. Nice reversal from Teresa. Teresa in the gut. Ooh, nice maneuver. Saving Shayla Dar. Save Shayla Dar from Rebecca. Takes out Rebecca to the outside. Teresa taking down Shayla Dar with the low dropkick maneuver. Down from Shayla Dar. No, Teresa, sorry, to Shayla Dar. Almost. And one count. Ooh, that's gotta hurt. Hurting Rebecca, that's gotta hurt. That is a dirty move. But then again, she is a heel, so. Outside suplex on Rebecca. And we're going to try to go back to the ring. Ooh, this guy hurt with that leg drop maneuver on Shayla Dar. This is a springboard. Ooh, what? Takedown maneuver from Rebecca. Justin Warren stops the count at one. Goes for a backstabber on Shadow Dar. Picks up Dar. Blocks a slap with a kick to the gut. Misses the kick. Ooh, nice save again from Angel Adams. Taking him down to Rusa. Rebecca going for a comeback. Clothesline at the clothesline. Ducks going for a third one. A jumping clothesline. Picks up Shadow Dar. Goes with the dragon cutter maneuver. Down the neck now of Shadow Dar. Teresa going for a finisher. No, nice reversal from Angel Adams. A major reversal on Teresa. Nice using the flag. Bucks out of the hole. Ooh, misses the Enziguri. And of course, Shadow Dar outside the ring. Picks up Dar. Picks up Shadow Dar. Sorry, I was going to take Gary Skies. Ooh, what a kick. Picks up Rebecca. Man, what a strength from Rebecca. Ducks. Takes down Shadow Dar with a kick to the back of the skull. Man, that just hurt when Shadow Dar in this matchup. Rebecca going up, Dar still. Angel Adams going up to Teresa still. Gets in the gut, gets in the leg. Gets it from Rebecca. Ooh, and Enziguri finally applied. Drags her away from the ropes. Pushing her both with a pin. One, two, gets out. Dar with the reversal now. Ooh, taking the arm of Rebecca. Ends it with a back suplex on Rebecca. And I think this is going for a move that I think she's going for. Ooh, what a reversal from Rebecca sitting there a mile away. Going for another suplex. Gets up quickly, going for a Falcon Arrow maneuver on Rebecca. Going for a roll up, that is new, goes for the pin. One. What the heck? Even now hit the rep, go for the pin. And you just sitting there. Just sitting there. Close line. Depth. Get to the face of Teresa. Man, he's just sitting there. That's the kick. See what's going on. Wait. So I have to restart the match. I just wanted to see what was going on. And for some odd reason, I knew was just sitting there. I just had to check to see what was going on. For some reason, I said, rope break. And yeah, it is. He's just sitting there. I just wanted to see what was going on. That was it. Ooh, powerbomb Shaladar outside the ring. So far, Teresa's still going after Dar. Rebecca's still going after Rebecca. Rebecca to the rope, to the Mount Sanders, sorry. And of course, submission maneuver, but it really doesn't count because it isn't a false count anywhere's matchup. Chick really, false count anywhere's matchup, tornado attack match. I don't know why I didn't do that, but. Chick same guys in the back. Reversal from Shaladar to Teresa. Sorry. Ooh, what a drop kick. Shaladar by the neck. Oh, I thought she was gonna send him onto the mat, but no. Going for a leg drop maneuver from the mat. Exactly with that air raid maneuver on Shaladar, well, on Angel Adams. Going to do those strikes on Angel Adams. Shaladar just. Get a Hurricanrana maneuver, strike, strike, into the corner, ends it with a clothesline, ends it with a bulldog to end the comeback, dragon cover maneuver from Rebecca, going for the Stang Shanai maneuver on Teresa, pushes away Rebecca, goes for a clothesline that misses, saves Teresa, saves her sister from the matchup. Reversal from Rebecca, reversal from Shaladar, kicks Rebecca in the gut, puts her in the corner, throws her outside. I'd be going for a suicide dive. Yes, she is. And pumped up. Runs to the ropes. And Supply pushes her onto the barricade. Teresa going for a glamour slam stretch on Angel Adams. Blocks the kick. Picks up Shaladar with a spine busting maneuver. Angel Adams with a reversal on Teresa. Picks up Teresa going for a suplex. But Teresa rolled outside the ring to recover her momentum. Jones with an elbow drop but misses. Reversal from Angel Adams picks up Teresa. Teresa with the reversal. Rebecca still going after Shaladar, just connecting with those slaps and kicks. Reversal from Dar with the kick to the gut. Kicks Rebecca on the shin. That just got hurt. Even though she applied the Boston Crab maneuver on Teresa, it is in a false count anywhere's matchup. Reversal from Angel Adams. Reversal from Teresa. Rebecca dragging. Rebecca going for the pin. One, two, kicks out. Punches Shaladar in the face. Picks up Dar from the ground. Dar with the reversal now. Going for a quick spine busting maneuver on Shaladar. Picks up Dar. Ooh, ends it with a enziguri. Enter. Goes for the pin. Saves Shaladar from the pin. Punches. Goes back on the face. Goes into the corner. For that outside suplex on Rebecca. Goes for the spine buster on Shaladar when she wasn't looking. Goes for the pin quickly. Kicks out the two count. Goes for the spine buster on Teresa. Teresa Goes for the black magic maneuver on Teresa. Goes for the pin quickly. Attacks the ref to stop the count. Reversal from Rebecca. Why is everybody attacking the ref? What did the ref do then? I see why he runs. Can't even go for the pin because he's knocked out. Can't be upset because it is your fault for attacking the ref. Goes for the clothesline on Rochelle Dar. Like, if she didn't attack the ref, I'm pretty sure she would have been in the game. Kicks out the two count. Rebecca goes for a clothesline to Teresa. Clothesline again. Ducks. Kicks Teresa in the face. Ooh, what a takedown maneuver from Shadow Guard to Rebecca. Rebecca with the reversal now. Screw maneuver. Ooh, what a takedown from the ladders. Nice move so far, Rebecca. On Shadow Dar. Implant Buster maneuver. Picks up Teresa. Hits on the gut. Goes for Kyle Brankton maneuver on Teresa. This is the finisher. Reversal from Rebecca. Reversal from Dar. Dar down the arm again. Maneuver. Now I'm trying to connect the black magic maneuver on her now. Oh wait, no. Goes for another one. Up to the face. Reversal. Kick. Blocks the kick. Outside, slipping onto the rope. Reversal. Kicks Rebecca outside the ring. With the reversal. Down the back of Rebecca. Back up, let's try to apply from Teresa. Sooner or later, we're gonna have a winner here, folks. That was for a neck breaking maneuver on Angel. Tap out for this matchup. Ooh, nice one from Teresa. Strike, strike, elbow strike, kick, and just with a knee shirt to the face. Goes for the submission yet again on Angel Adams. Does not tap out. Rock kick. Applied on Teresa. Ooh, and the Gary is applied. And we have to go for the pin if you're gonna, if you want to win. Too late. Too late. You should have gone for the pin instead of just sitting there. Goes for the cow-breaking maneuver on Rebecca. Reversal from Rebecca. Reversal from Angel. Carson and Rebecca. Next matchup, we got Vanessa Charms going against Alexia Banks. Here we go.
Making her way to the ring.
Oh, snap. Oh, snap. Huh. I did not expect Candy Vega to attack Vanessa Charms. That's gotta hurt. Goes for a DDT maneuver onto that ramp, that steel ramp. From Vanessa with that first DDT maneuver. Gets comes into the ring. She was supposed to face Alexia Banks, but I think the ref is gone. Gets thrown to the corner. Drop kick. Gets thrown outside the ring. Nice reversal from Vanessa. Takes her down, pushes away Vanessa. Ooh, knee strike to the face. Goes for an elbow drop. Goes back into the ring. Kicks Vanessa in the back. Goes for a clothesline. But consider this a no contest because Kane DeVega attacked. Okay, then our next matchup is Tessa going against Candace. Then go with our next matchup.
Making her way to the ring from St. Louis, Missouri, Teresa.
Tessa making her way to the ring, getting ready for a matchup against none other than Candace Charms.
And her opponent, from Hollywood, California, K.A.T.
Candace Charms making her way to the ring, getting ready for a matchup against Tessa. So we'll see how this matchup turns out. Second to last matchup of the evening, Tessa versus Candace Charms. Puts Tessa in the corner. Tessa has no choice but to break it up. Ooh, what a sucker punch from Candace. Got Candace in the back. Slams down Candace, goes for the headlock. Punches Candace in the face. Reversal from Tessa. reversal from Candace. Kicks Dustin back, sending her head down to the ground. Picks up Tessa, and Tessa with the jawbreaker maneuver. Kicks Candace in the ground, comes to the ropes, comes in with it. Ooh, sending that freaking maneuver. Reversal from Candace. Reversal from Tessa. Checks on Candace Charms. Picks up Candace. Candace with the jawbreaker maneuver. Comes in with a boot to the face. Goes for a finish and we had to kill. Picks up Candace from the corner. Picks up Candace with the that move yet again. Goes for the pin. She won the matchup. Now moving on to our main event. Than Toni Rose going against Natasha Charms. Here we go with our main event, y'all. Main event of the evening.
Contest is a no disqualifications match. Making her way to the ring from New York, Car Marie.
Toni Rose making her way to the ring. Natasha Charms making her way to the ring.
And her opponent, from Newcastle upon Tyne, England, the Princess N.A.T.
Thank you.
this will be an interesting event with Natasha Charles going against Tony Rose. And here we go with our main event. Natasha Charles going against Tony Rose. Got the arm. Puts Tony to her knees. Got the upper hand on Tony in that one. Northern Light suplex is applied, picks up Tony Rose. Tony Rose with the reversal now. Strike. Puts on the corner.
Just connecting him with kicks and punches, like what?
This one came early. Kicks out of the one count. He just wants to finish up this matchup early. Throws and tosses over the ropes, ducks. Goes from the arm drag. Tony Rose showing a whole different side of herself. Reversal from Natasha on the back now. Rose. Ouch, that's gotta hurt. Grabs the arm. Stomp. Onto the hand. Picks up. Tony Rose misses a kick. Throws her to the corner. Now puts her in the corner. Love Wolf stomps on Tony Rose, flips her off, and ends it with a last stomp. Goes for the pin. One, no kicks out. Almost at the knee strike, but no reversal from Tony Rose. Kicks on the gut. Nice spear from Natasha. Picks up Tony. Almost at that maneuver applied. Reverse. Nice maneuver. Now it's applied. Her to stop moving so she can charge up her finisher on Tony Rose. Almost at the spear, but Rose saw that a mile away. Eleven maneuvers using that turnbuckle as a weapon reversal from Natasha. Gets down to the rope. Still coming. Just thrown back in. Goes for the pin. Gets out of the pin. Knee strike to the back of Matt. Hits up Matt. Goes for a signature maneuver on Natasha. Turns on Randy. Attacks the arm now. Turns around. It with that arm breaking the move on Natasha. Ducks, nice maneuver. Throws Natasha to the corner. Ooh, nice reversal. Arms at the kick. Back suplex is applied.
Here is your winner, Car Murray.
Cody Rhodes gets the win. Congratulations to Tony Rose on the win. Thank you for watching Triforce Women's Wrestling. I'm your host, Tyler Cage. I'm about to sign off. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys this Sunday for No Escape. Thank you for watching this wonderful show. Almost, like, literally the only thing that shocked me throughout this stream was when Lilith Ramirez attacked Alexia Starrs the way that she did. So I will see you guys Sunday. Have a good evening, have a good night, and have a good morning.